All right, day two. I am going to go downstairs and do a little workout, come back, shower, hit up a coffee shop, grab lunch, a little bit of a full itinerary. The day kind of opens up towards the evening time. So let's get going.
We're going full Nike.
And then these are gonna be the shoes that I work out in because they're super comfortable. I mean, they're technically running shoes. We got some, of course, the Beats Pro, only the best. In case you guys forgot, this is what it looks like. So it's a decent little fitness center. I remember that they had gloves here last time, so this time I actually brought wraps. Just some Everlasts. This one's a lot better than this one. This one's really bad actually, but fuck. This lighting though, yo, got me looking kinda, you feel me? Rito season. I really gotta up my fitness, no joke. But Joe, it's low-key pretty cold. I don't know why people are out in t-shirts. Like, shit's sweet. It is not sweet. I'm wearing a light bomber and I'm still freezing right now.
feel like when people come to Portland or vlog these like West Coast cities where like the homeless population is pronounced, they don't really like to show it, but I don't know, I have a different outlook when it comes to homelessness. Maybe I'll share it in a bit, but it's just unfortunate, man. You see that right there? It just continues. See what I'm saying? Going to this coffee shop right here, I typically don't fall for like gimmicky stuff like this, but they do like some pretty cool, like unique latte art. And this place was recommended to me. Like their non-existent Chinatown. There's dead ass like more homeless people than there are Chinese people here in Portland. Like not even trying to make a joke. Oh, by the way, I'm going to the Lansu Chinese Garden right now because it's like so close to that coffee shop. Little garden. It reminds me of like gardens in like Hong Kong and China where they just be randomly placed. Like this one's placed like in the middle of the city, you know?
The sun sets over my head.
Black Dragon Oolong Tea. This is too funny. Yo, this is tough. This is tough for sure.
Lansu Garden. It's a nice little garden for sure. They have a mandarin duck in the pond. Right now I'm gonna go look at some cherry blossoms.
Jesus, how did they get so much? The nostalgia is hitting right now, yo.
This whole stretch are cherry blossoms. Wow, that was such a little vibe. Like, shit, there's so many cherry blossoms. Everyone's just getting flicks. Right now I'm gonna go to lunch at Murata. History tends to repeat itself. I try to carry water and drink water on vacation, but it ends up biting me back in the ass because then I can't find a restroom and then I have to carry this water that I'm not drinking. God fucking damn it. On the flip side, if I don't drink water, then I get dehydrated and I get a headache. You just can't win. Yes, bro, we finally made it.
So hungry.
Murata restaurant, second time going there. That sake got me feeling some type of way right now. Not gonna lie, I'm sauced. You could probably see the Asian glow even. Man, that was just such a proper meal. Now I'm gonna head back to the hotel and just bowl, charge my phone, figure out what I'm gonna do later today. Pretty productive so far, so I think I deserve a little break. Man, I'm dead ass. Like, if there's somewhere you're trying to go, just do it, dolo. Fuck it, you know what I mean? I'm here by myself. I'm having the time of my life. If I'm lying, I'm dying.
Back here on the bottom, water bottle. Love this water bottle. Another little outfit change. Gonna throw on the New Balances. I'm going to a dispo to pick up some pre-rolls, and then I'm still trying to figure out what I'm gonna get for dinner, but we'll see. Before I head out, I promise to talk about homelessness. So that's what I'm gonna do right now. Homelessness, okay. It is crazy pronounced here. I showed you guys a little bit of footage. That's a sad reality of Portland and a lot of these West Coast cities that have more favorable weather. In Chicago, it gets so cold in the winter, you will die if you're out there in the streets overnight. You get what I'm saying? But I feel like there's this narrative that society pushes, and it's like something like homeless people are lazy, go get a job. You know, why don't you just get a job? Like, as if it's that easy. First of all, I hesitate to call them lazy because homelessness can happen to a lot of, at least Americans, because many Americans do live check to check. All it takes is, you know, injury, getting laid off, miss a check here, miss rent, eviction. It can happen really fast. So I hesitate to judge so heavily, you know? It's very tricky when it comes to like giving money to homeless people. My outlook would be, I would rather buy them food and not offer them food. Offering them food and buying them food are two different things. A lot of people also think that like, I'm gonna offer you my scraps or whatever I ordered from XYZ, I don't know, McDonald's. Yeah, they have a right to decline your offer. They have preferences. They lived a life prior to homelessness, you know? There are allergies, you know? Like, why would you just assume that you can give, like, whatever it is you have to them and they just, like, have to, like, open arms, like, accept whatever it is you're giving them? That's absurd. And they have preferences. Like, maybe I don't like seafood, or maybe I don't like meat, or maybe I don't drink coffee, I drink tea, or you know what I mean? Like, and then people are like, I don't give money because they're gonna spend it on drugs. Fam, think about it. Think about it like this. If you are homeless, you know, if your life fucking sucks, wouldn't you lean on drugs? I would. I'll say that with my chest, bro. Like, what? I would be craving that, like, moment, you know, escape from this, like, sad reality of being homeless and being on an empty stomach 24/7 and being cold and whatever, you know? Or on the flip side, imagine you have a drug addiction. How are you gonna combat withdrawal symptoms when you don't have a roof over your head without like social support? Like, fuck that. I am not dealing with withdrawal symptoms and homelessness. You know what I mean? Simultaneously, like that's, no, absolutely not. So like you need to be very mindful when we judge, you know, the disposition of homeless people. Very insensitive, this narrative that society pushes. So I just wanted to speak on that because, you know, I empathize for homeless people. I don't think it's practical for me to just hand out money to every single homeless person that I see. You know what I mean? Like if I'm going to school and I see the same homeless person every like four days out of the week, every week, like I can't just give them $5 every day or whatever increment, you know what I mean? Or like living in Portland where you see homeless people every corner, like I don't have the means to like help them. And seeing them just like brings like my spirits down, brings like morale is low, you know what I mean? Like it can be kind of grim. So felt like I rambled a little bit, but yeah, the point is like don't judge homeless people because like for example, getting a job, like, where is your CV? Where's your resume? Where is your email? Where is like how am I gonna contact you? Where's your phone? Where is your white professionalism work attire? You feel me? Like where is how are you gonna shower and come to work? Like, how are you gonna come back to and from work every day consistently? How are you gonna maintain that job even if you make it that far and like actually land a job as a homeless person? You know what I mean? And like, I don't know how true this is, but I've heard that like
certain cities where like homeless people have like all of their paperwork and stuff. When like city trucks come to sweep, they just throw everything away. So some of these people don't even have their IDs. They don't have any of like their important paperwork. So super insensitive to be like, go get a job, you're lazy, or like you should accept whatever I'm giving you, like take it or leave it type of like mentality, or like you're just gonna use it on drugs. Like, bro, like think, use your fucking critical thinking skills. You feel me?
J Dilla in the AirPods. It's nice as fuck out right now.
I'm back at the hotel. I was feeling lazy, and then having that little spark sesh definitely did not help in terms of like energy and vitality. You feel me? Like, now I just don't want to do shit. Like, I'm about to start snacking and I might even knock out. But hopefully I wake up in time to, like, go out and grab, like, a bowl of ramen or something at the very least. I'm chilling, though, bro. Like, this is very relaxed. I'm not even trying to, like, go out and do too much right now. Apparently this movie is proper. I just found it on Netflix on some, like, blog. It's about heart surgeons.
Definitely didn't hit the same, but it's whatever.